Hi, it is Monday again. Mondays roll around so fast. Motivational Monday with Maureen. Happy to be outside in this beautiful weather we have. I feel like we're squeezing out every second of our summer, but I hope you're enjoying it somehow. I have another tip for you, of course, along with scripture. So I wanted to really encourage you guys to be Jesus's disciples. You know, we could be casual friends there. Jesus had a lot of casual friends. You could be a casual friend. You could be part of his 12. You could be part of his inner circle. You know, what are you and who do you want to be? I feel like the more of God's goodness that we taste, the more we want to be closer to him. And so I feel like this, it's not the last tip, but this tip is probably not talked about a lot in our society. I feel like it's kind of lost among a lot of Christians, and it's fasting. I don't think anybody likes to fast. I don't know anybody who doesn't like to eat. And even though you can fast other things, you could fast off of, you know, social media or television. Those things are also very good to fast from, you know, so you can spend more time with the Lord. But for me, I have gotten the most out of actually abstaining from food. And it's not something that you can, I think it's not healthy to do just start today. You hear Maureen talk about fasting, and so you're just going to start fasting. You really want to work up to it. You want to do it, you know, in a good way, so you get the most out of it. And so I just really wanted to encourage you to look into fasting, because it draws us closer to the Lord. I mean, if you're having any trouble, and I don't know who doesn't, things that you want different in your life, and you know, today you're gonna wage war on it, and that's what you're gonna focus on today, but you just can't seem to get a breakthrough, you know, fasting helps you there. We get closer to the Lord when we fast. We're able to hear his voice. We're telling our body who's boss. You know, you're not telling me what to do, body. My spirit and my soul are in charge, you know, and we bring those closer to the Lord when we fast. And I just, you know, practical, you can start by a couple of days of just eating a little bit less, and then you go with, you know, if you're working, what's easier for you, to skip eating during the day? Well, you know, you have to kind of find out what works for you, but don't just skip a meal or fast for a day. You want to have that time to spend with the Lord. I mean, we're not just going without food. We are taking that time and spending it with the Lord. And we're asking him, Lord, would you draw me closer to you? Lord, would you help my spirit get stronger? You know, these are all the things that fasting does. I love it. You know, I mean, you're serious when you're going to give up something that, you know, sustains your life. Fasting. You're seriously pursuing the Lord. And it even helps you pursue the Lord, because the Lord wants us to do that. I love in his Sermon on the Mount, in 5:6 on Matthew, he says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. You know, if you're hungering and thirsting for him instead of food for that, you know, time period, he's going to satisfy you. And I love, you know, Jesus fasted. How much more should we fast, you know? And he says also, go flip the next page over into Matthew 6. He says, you know, when you fast. He doesn't say if you fast. He says when you fast. And then he goes on to tell you that you know, don't make your fasting noticeable to men, you know, so you draw attention to yourself. But, you know, do it in secret. Fast in secret. And it says that your Heavenly Father, who sees in secret what's done, will reward you. He's going to reward you for the things that you fast for. He will. And, you know, the best thing is that we're going to get to hear his heart better when you fast. So, you know, the Bible doesn't tell you how to fast. There's lots of things on the internet that can help you with that, that tell you how to get to that place and all the different kinds. And you start out by intentionally fasting. But sometimes the Lord will just drop in your spirit that he wants you to fast, and he wants you to fast for a specific reason. But you have to start. You know, he's not going to tell you something that you're not going to do. So you start yourself. So there is some motivation on fasting and some good scriptures. So I love you guys. I will talk to you next week.